we have received a mandate to assist with our national COVID testing efforts, and we are so excited and so thrilled to be able to participate and to be able to contribute to expanding our national testing capacity, because we understand that we are having this third surge in COVID-19 cases, and we want to be able to assist the efforts so that we can quickly identify those among us who are sick, and so that they can be treated and take the numbers down. So much preparation has gone into this, and we had to ensure that our facilities were up to standard for COVID-19 testing. Similarly, we had to ensure that we had all of our protocols in place. We're piggybacking off of the technology that we already use for DNA technology, and that is for DNA testing, sorry, and that is PCR technology. So that aspect of it we already do, and we've been doing it since 2010. However, we had to tweak certain things because now we're working with a virus. And so we had to tweak our protocols to be able to accommodate the COVID-19 testing in our environment. Then we have to ensure that the kits that we're using are up to standard. So we have to validate them. We had to get samples to be able to do that. It's just building good quality assurance. It is to establish good quality assurance practice and procedure to ensure that the end result of our testing is of sound quality and can be relied upon consistently. Well, I have to say that I must congratulate my team and say how proud I am of this team. When we first encountered the virus in St. Lucia in March, at the end of March, recognizing that we had the training for PCR testing, we partnered with the OKEU laboratory to train them to do PCR testing. So half of my staff, including myself, went over there for a couple of months. And during that time, the other half of the staff remained here, and they were able to cut down on our backlog cases and significantly reduce it. So much so our chemistry department doesn't have a backlog anymore. They're current. As cases come in, they get worked on. And so that really improved the efficiency at the laboratory. When we returned from OKEU, we went full throttle into our quality assurance to get the laboratory accredited. So we were able to develop our quality management system, put our procedures and our protocol in place to be ready for accreditation. We're on the final leg of that, in January, February 2021. With respect to the support from the government of St. Lucia, it's been phenomenal. With restarting our DNA service, and this is the heart of where the COVID testing will be taking place as well. We have purchased two new pieces of equipment. The first one is going to be shipped in short order. It's which upgrades our DNA machines. We have kind of a bottom of the rung machine at the moment. Actually, the first generation genetic analyzer, the machine that produces the DNA profile. We have a first generation one, but with the approvals from the government, we have purchased an upgrade to one that has four capillaries as opposed to one capillary, so we can do four samples at any one time. And further to that, we recently received approval from the Minister of Finance to purchase a machine that will allow us to do genetic sequencing. So you know the sequencing that they talk about, trying to sequence the virus, the COVID-19 virus. We will have that capability with this new piece of equipment that we will be getting shortly. So the support has been tremendous, and we've also acquired new staff. We have two new staff members on board, and we hopefully will be getting a third one in very short order as well. So we just continue to build the capacity of the laboratory so that the lab can be relevant to our society and we can really have an impact on criminal activity or criminal investigations, I should say.